Hey, this is Frank. We are looking at a Toyota 2.4 liter 2AZ-FE 4-cylinder engine. This engine is found in many different cars like Toyota Highlander, Toyota RAV4, Toyota Camry, also in the first generation Scion TC. This particular engine here on the stand had excessive oil consumption. It was burning more than a quart of oil within every 1,000 miles, even more than that. So we've replaced it with a replacement engine in the vehicle. But in this video, we're going to take apart this engine and try to see if we can find anything that would explain why this engine was burning so much oil. I started breaking down this engine. I removed the timing cover. I removed the valve cover. I removed the timing chain and the principal timing chain. I have to remove the oil pump secondary timing chain, but to do that, I have to remove the oil pump first. And right now, I'm going to remove the camshafts. So you'll notice I did not follow the order of the manual. I'm just removing these in any order. It doesn't matter. This engine is going to be discarded. So these are bi-hexagon head bolts, and this is the bi-hexagon tool that you use for removing them. It is not a triple square, okay? This is different from a triple square. And this is a 10 millimeter bi-hexagon. So to break these bolts loose, break these head bolts loose, I've turned the engine on its side so I can apply leverage downwards. And using this long extension, so if you were thinking of doing this in the car, good luck with that. So the head is off, and I'm going to take a closer look at the head in a minute. But first, let's look at the block. And before we even get started, I want to show you something that will have you going Whiskey Tango Foxtrot. Yeah, Whiskey Tango Foxtrot. This thing is inside the cylinder block. And what it does there, I have no idea. But one thing I tell you for sure, I would never want a thing like this inside any engine of mine. And I don't know who had the bright idea to put it in this engine. Okay, so now let's look at these cylinders and pistons. I'm going to bring them into view for you by turning the crank. Here come number one and number four. And look at this. This is like the most disgusting piston top that I have ever seen. Okay, so it has a, of course there's some dirt from the shop, but what these had on them is just some incredible sludge residue, carbon residue. Let me scrape some of this off. I'm just going to see what I can scrape off with this razor. Okay, you can see the stuff that just comes off. Let's try this one here. All right, you can see this stuff is just all over the top of the piston. And it's in a semi-liquid state, a sludgy state. Let's try the other two pistons. Pretty much the same story here, just an accumulation of sludge on every piston top. And just about as bad as you can get with a running engine. And here is the head. I've put it on this former beach towel, which is now a shop towel. And let's take a close look. Now, honestly, I had never ever seen anything this horrible. And I don't even know where to start with this. Maybe I'll pop out some of these valves to take a look at the back of the valves. But I don't really even know how to describe this. Let's see if this disgusting white stuff can be scraped off. And yeah, you can scrape it off, but it's pretty solidly hardened onto the valve. And I don't know what this is or how it got there. I mean, the color white sometimes, I mean, often indicates coolant, but this engine did not have any coolant leaks, and it did not have any head gasket problems whatsoever. It was removed because it was burning oil, and I don't know what this white stuff is. So now let's take a quick look at how we can pop out these valves. I use this tool. It's called, Toyo tool. Imagine that. Okay, so there we go. I got a magnetic little end, and you quickly pick up the keepers and the retainer. And yes, this is how quickly you can do it with this tool. All right, so let's see, what do we have here? Oh my Lord. Again, I have absolutely no idea what that might be. Look at how the face of the valve is caked with stuff. And these intake valves are not too bad, but the exhaust valves, they really suffered. I have flipped the engine so we can take a look, see what's underneath. We're going to remove this upper oil pan. I've already removed the lower oil pan. One thing you must be aware of is this oil filter boss right here. There is a hidden bolt that is right down through the middle of this oil filter boss. And if you want to remove the upper oil pan, you must reach down there with a 12 millimeter socket to get this bolt out. Otherwise, this upper oil pan remains attached to the block. And to remove this, you need a 12 millimeter hex. So this is the oil pump. It has a secondary chain that goes to the crankshaft. It's attached by some bolts. It comes right off. Okay, so this is unlike other Toyota motors where the oil pump is driven in the timing cover. Now, this is the cover for the counterweights, and he just removed the bolts of the cover. And these are the counterweights. Take them off, and they're driven by the crankshaft through these gears. And I don't know if on this motor anybody bothers to remove the counterweights. It would certainly increase the amount of noise and vibration. Maybe it would lead to a little bit better performance. I don't know. So the all we have to do now to get the pistons out is undo the bottom ends of the rods. And these are 12 point. Let's go ahead and unfasten them all. And I'm going to see if I can just push this piston out the bottom. There, it's coming right out. And here is one of our pistons. And oh boy, look at these oil control rings. Look at this oil control ring. So, like, no wonder that this burned oil. Let's look at the other one. Okay, this is as far as we are going to go with this teardown. To summarize, what we have is oil control rings that are completely clogged up. We have exhaust valves that look to be, I don't know, would you call this burned? I would. And then we have scoring on the cylinder walls. So none of these are very positive signs. So anyway, this engine, we had judged it to be dead already. So it's nothing to be concerned about. Here it's going, we've replaced it already with another engine and in the vehicle that it came from. And this one is going to the scrapyard. Hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you for watching.